Ah, hello there. It's been quite some time since I've had any visitors. And what have we here? Oh, such an exquisite beauty. I saw many a beautiful princess back at the castle. But you, my dear, oh, you outshine them all. Indeed, oh, indeed. It's easy to see why your fellow travelers guard you so closely.
What? You saying you can see the horse princess all proper like?
Of course he can! Even as a horse, her inner beauty shines through. That's right, my darling. Wait a moment. How can you recognize this horse as my beautiful princess?
A horse, you say? How curious. Please excuse me, princess. Indeed, here is her mane and her tail. She is a horse. Curiouser and curiouser. As you can see, my sight failed me long ago. Now I view the world through my mind's eye instead. And what it sees is a princess, not a beast of burden. Curious travelers, might you tell me what has happened here? I see. So, a curse has been placed upon her. Now, I may just have a way to return her to her former self. Yes. Why don't we give it a try?
Really? Where? How?
Girl, blimey, don't sneak up on me like that!
What are you flapping about? I've been here the whole time, you twit!
I can't say for sure if it will work, but have her drink from the spring. Its enchanted waters have been known to lift curses. Why don't you try it and see?
Father? Father, look! I've returned to normal! What's wrong, Father? Why aren't you saying anything? Am I just dreaming? Or is this some new trickery?
No! No, my dear. I'm sorry. It's just that you take my breath away. Come here and let me look at you.
Oh, Father.
Medea, my darling Medea. I'm so sorry for making you pull the carriage. It must have been so hard for you. I promise, I'll make it up to you.
Oh no, Father. You mustn't worry. This isn't just about me. I'm just happy that I could be of service to everyone.
That's my Medea. Well, it's high time I restored my own visage to its former glory.
Father?
What's wrong? Medea! Oh, my princess! What is this new devilry? It seems our celebrations were premature.
The curse placed upon the princess must be strong indeed. If the waters don't work, there is but one path left open to you. You must find and defeat the one who placed the curse upon her, Dulmagus. It is the only way to restore the princess to her true form. You must persevere, no matter how long and hard the road ahead. And now I pray you'll excuse me. My old bones get chilled so easily.
Oh, my precious princess. What a cruel disappointment. Still, we must carry on. Let us redouble our efforts to bring Dulmagus to account for his sins.
I'm terribly sorry to behave so selfishly, but I have a favor to ask. I'm only human for the briefest of moments after drinking from the spring. But it would make me very happy if you could bring me back here every now and then. I'd like to be able to talk to you again, just like we used to, back at the castle. We can forget all about the curse, even if it's only for the few minutes we share together. I can feel the enchantment wearing off.
Consider it as a request from me as well. She asks for so little of us, it really is the least we can do. Actually, no. Think of it as an order. Understood? Very well. Now that that's decided, we can move on.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Your Majesty, are you feeling poorly? Did those travelers cause you some trouble?
No, I'm fine. One of them reminded me of someone, but I must be mistaken. The magic mirror? But it's a precious royal heirloom. Why on earth do you require it? Explain yourself. I understand. However, as I have said, the magic mirror is a treasure of the royal family. I cannot simply give it to you.
I knew he'd say no.
C'est la vie, I suppose. It was a lot to ask.
So now what? How are we going to avenge my brother's death without that mirror?
If what you say is true, you must have survived a great many ordeals on your travels. That means your fighting skills must be on a par with those of my soldiers.
But, Your Majesty, you can't possibly plan to use those travelers instead of royal guardsmen.
Well surmised, Chancellor. Listen to me carefully. I rule with a fair hand, but I cannot grant every request that is made of me. However, if the royal family owes someone a debt of gratitude, I consider it my duty to fulfill it. You need the magic mirror. Then accept my request. If you complete the task I set forth for you, you may have the mirror. Summon the prince!
At once, Your Majesty.
The request concerns my son, Prince Charmels, to become King of Argonia. One must undertake a special initiation ceremony. There is some risk to life and limb, and the prince is unwilling to do it. As a father, the thought of putting my own son in danger pains me. But he must pass the initiation if he is to succeed me to the throne. It is the tradition of our kingdom. I was considering sending a detail of royal soldiers to protect him during the rite. However, I fear it will ruin his reputation. So my request is this. You outsiders will accompany my son to the royal hunting ground. Naturally, this would remain completely confidential. It is vital that everyone believes my son passed the initiation on his own.
Your Majesty, Prince Charmels is...
What is it this time?
The prince has run off again. I'm extremely sorry, Your Majesty. This is all my fault. I'll bring Prince Charmels to Your Majesty as soon as we can find him. As your humble and faithful servant, I beg...
You incompetent fool! Please pardon my outburst. But we cannot continue this discussion without my son.
Is there something on my head? Ah! Ah! Ick! Ick! A lizard! What's it doing here? Get it out! Get it out!